second month. Here we go.
Whew.
All right. Before we start, we just want to be reminded what's in it for us in undertaking this challenge, because this will only get harder as time progresses. And the link will be in the description if you'd like to check it out, if you're more fond of reading than listening. Put simply, I would be doubling the requirements for this month. So here are the 7 days of the week, and I'm plotting the days that I will be resting as well as the days that I'll be working out. For each workout day, I would be performing 4 sets, which equals to 40 repetitions a day, done in bursts of 10. Now to demonstrate what I've mastered over the course of 1 month. So this is what 1 set looks like right now. And I've actually gotten feedback that I am locking my elbows. So if you notice, when I ascend, I would actually kind of lock my arm. It's too tense, and it's not supposed to be that way because you're going to hurt your joints. But I do notice that I am making more rhythmic and sustained movements, which to me is a good improvement to start. I'm surprised with how smoothly I eased into the additional workload. I guess month one did a good job in accustoming my muscle memory to this kind of pressure. I realized that by closing my eyes and removing the visual distractions, I begin to understand my body a bit more. And the more I could understand how locking your elbows when you ascend would hurt your joints in the long run, because it suddenly shifts all the tension to your delicate joints. So I have not mastered the move yet, but I'm beginning to understand my body a bit more just by closing my eyes. If you're having problems like me, like you're locking your elbow whenever you ascend from a push-up, I've thought of an analogy while doing the exercise. So you could compare it to driving a car at full speed and suddenly hitting the brakes to put the car to an abrupt halt. Even with the seatbelt on, there is a chance that you might hurt yourself because of the recoil from that act. So you would like to do the push-up as fluidly as you can and only hit the brakes when you're done with your entire set, if that makes sense. I was actually feeling my muscles, my core, my arms, my chest, especially my triceps. I could feel them moving, working, being broken down, stretched. So I think I'm getting it. I think I'm getting the movement. I just completed my first session for week 2, and I must say that my arms are still being accustomed to handling all that weight. I find that not both arms are equally strong, so I have to work on that. And I find that it's kind of tough on your first session for the week when you've had, in my case, 3 consecutive days of rest. But other than that, it's manageable. It helps to recall the concepts that I've learned. So I have 3 important ones. So number 1, close your eyes. Number 2, do not lock the elbows. And number 3, what was number 3? Oh yes, synchronize your breathing. So I try to make all of those come together. It's not easy, but that's what I'm trying to do in order to improve this month. I'm still trying to apply all the things that I've learned so far, and slowly but surely, I feel that my arms and the rest of my body are getting stronger, and I am getting a better grasp of what the correct movement is like and how it's supposed to feel. And it's good. I'm having a long weekend because of the special Philippine holiday, and I'm actually in my Cavite home. And it's quite discouraging if you suddenly get exposed to a new environment. You don't know where to set up. I'm actually in my kitchen because this is a good free place at this time to exercise. And I'm I almost did not exercise, but I just thought that can't be the message that I'm going to send to my audience who are traveling or who doesn't really stay in one place. So if your environment is constantly changing, you have to consciously put an effort into finding a setup that works for you so that you can still exercise. And that's why bodyweight exercises are very, very beneficial, because you basically need your own body and a sufficient amount of space, and you're all set. The first workout of the week after 3 consecutive days of rest still remains to be the hardest one. And for this session, I actually experimented with my arms. So I noticed that they're gaining strength, and I tried just short breaths. So since I am synchronizing my body movement with my breath, I did not push myself to the floor as hard as usual. And I now see how the different variations that target different muscle groups could be derived from simple changes such as that. We should never ignore our own bodies. Say, for example, if you've seen my LCIF challenge video, I ignored my hunger during my first week and ended up losing a lot more weight than I should be. So, translating to this, my body, the arms specifically, is kind of hurting for today. So what I did is I slowed down, I relaxed the intensity of my push-up, and I ended up getting through like all the sets that I need to complete. I feel like if I did not do that, I would not complete the workout and I might have suffered an injury. So do not ignore your body, people. Listen to it. Today's session was unusually easy. So if you remember yesterday, I relaxed my workout because of the pain in my arm, but now it's gone, so I actually intensified the training a bit. So it's just a trade-off that I'm willing to make. I'm definitely making progress in terms of strength, although the strength of my arms are still uneven, like one arm is stronger than the other. And I can say with a bit of confidence that I'm actually mastering the move. Like, I don't lock my elbows anymore whenever I ascend from a push-up. My first session of the week is still hard, but it's not as hard compared to the last 3 weeks. And I also noticed that my strength is more evenly distributed right now, and my weight is being carried, or rather supported, by the rest of my body more stably. Is that a word? Stably? There. Definitely feel stronger, and I'm kind of feeling courageous to try a lower, more intense push-up. So I'll be sure to let you know. So like I said, I tried amping up the intensity of my workout, and I'm surprised that my body was able to keep up. And I just did it so subtly, like I tried to push myself down lower to the ground, and it provided to be more challenging, and it's great. It's reassuring that my strength is more evenly distributed. So I discovered that push-ups can be made more challenging in two ways. Number one, intensity. You can like push yourself down lower to the ground, or two, speed. It's quite obvious, but until you do it, you don't realize it that much. So even though I haven't mastered my form yet, that feeling of being stronger is already a win for me. And I have two main takeaways for this month. Number one, with any workout, the most important thing is to be consistent at it. Like whatever challenge comes your way, there's always a problem. You just have to consciously find a solution. And number two, the results actually get better the more you go into the exercise. So don't stop, please. Just don't stop. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and let me know what you think in the comments. And also, if you're interested in seeing more content like this, make sure to hit that subscribe button as well as that notification bell so you're always updated whenever I upload new content. Thanks for watching and have a great day.